This video guides you through the batch export process in Informatica's Reference 360. You can use the batch export process to export code lists from Reference 360. We'll export data from a code list of country codes to a flat file. But before we dive in and export code lists in Reference 360, we'll need to first discuss some prerequisites for your environment. After that, we'll move on to configuring data integration. And finally, we'll go over how to set up and run the export job in Reference 360. Let's begin. First, let's cover the prerequisites needed to run a batch export job. You'll need a secure agent and two connections to run the job. For this demo, we have a Business 360 and a flat file connection already configured. Since our prerequisites are covered, we can now configure data integration. There are three configuration steps we have to complete. First, create a mapping, then create a mapping task, and finally, we'll create a task flow. First, let's create our mapping. And then name the mapping. Now, let's configure the source. Under the Source tab, let's select the Business 360 connection. Then select the code list to export under that connection. Now let's configure the target. This time, we'll select the Target tab to configure the target connection. And then we will select an object. For target object, we'll select Create New at Runtime, and then enter a file name for the exported CSV. Now we'll connect the source and target. Now we need to add an in-out parameter to track the job instance. We must name this parameter job instance ID exactly as shown, since this field is case sensitive. Now let's save the mapping. And just like that, we've finished the first part of the export configuration. Next, we need to create a mapping task from this mapping. Let's give this mapping task a name. And select the runtime environment containing our secure agent. Double check that the in-out parameter is configured correctly. Then we can skip the last step and click Finish on the wizard. Now that we've created the mapping task, we can move on to creating a task flow. First, let's give the task flow a name. Next, under the Input Fields tab, we will add an input field that corresponds with our in-out parameter. Remember, this field is case sensitive, so enter job instance ID exactly as shown. Now we'll add a data task to the task flow by dragging it from the menu on the left. Now to configure the data task, we will select the mapping task we created in the last step. Now we need to add an input field to the data task for our in-out parameter. Now let's edit the input field. We need to select Field from the drop-down menu, and then select our in-out parameter to pass along the job instance ID. Now, let's save our task flow. And finally, we will publish the task flow so it's ready to run. That completes the required configuration and data integration. So, let's switch over to Reference 360. Now that we're in Reference 360, let's create our reference data export job. First, we'll need to name the job. Before we continue, let's discuss the three types of exports you can perform. Standard export. When the job is first run, all the records will be exported. Then, for every subsequent run, added or updated records are incrementally exported. Custom export. When the job is first run, it exports all the records that have been added or modified after the selected date. Then, for every subsequent run, added or updated records are incrementally exported. Export all simply exports all the records each time the job is run. Let's select Standard Export. Now we will add the task flow we created in data integration. Since we've configured everything correctly, Reference 360 will automatically detect which assets to export and populate the list of assets on the right. With everything set, we can save the export job. Now we're ready to run. We can review the status of the job on the My Jobs page. And just like that, the export job is complete. The job definition can also be run using schedules. Let's create a new job schedule to run the job for us. Since we don't have any schedules configured yet, we'll create one. And it's just that easy. To recap, to export code lists, in Informatica Administrator, you'll need a runtime environment with a secure agent and two configured connections. In data integration, you'll need to configure three assets, a mapping task, and a task flow. Finally, in Reference 360, you can create the reference data export job and schedule it. For more information, go to the Informatica documentation portal, visit our communities and support hubs, or check out our website.